Hello and welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Melanie Denton Dombrowski with Salisbury Eye Care and Eyewear. And today I have a hotly requested video that everybody's been asking for in our comments. We are gonna talk a little bit about transitions again, but this time I'm gonna show you how they perform in a car. So just to set the stage a little bit for you, we're here in North Carolina. It's the end of September and we've picked a pretty sunny day. I am in my car, I'm not driving it, but just for the purposes of showing you how the lenses change in my vehicle, we're using the car. I'm gonna show you three different lenses today. So we're gonna look at Transition Signature 7. Now this lens is on its way out. It's been replaced with the Generation 8 lens this summer. However, it's just kind of neat to show you because if you've been wearing the Signature 7, it'll be nice to compare it to the Gen 8 so that next time you go to your eye doctor, you'll kind of know that difference between Gen 8 and Sig 7. So the other lens we're going to show you is the Xtractive. And the reason why this is interesting is so Signature 7 and Gen 8, those are kind of in the regular transitions realm. That's how most people will refer to them. And Xtractive is the type of lens that's gonna get a little bit darker behind a car windshield. So I wanna illustrate for you today exactly how much darker they're gonna get. I do wanna mention that I am affiliated with Transitions and that I am a change agent for them. I'm not being compensated for this video. However, I do get some of my lenses from them and a couple of the pairs I'm showing you today, they actually made for me. So as we get started, we're gonna do a couple of things. I wanna show you each of the lenses here in the vehicle with my sunroof totally closed, and then we'll go ahead and open the sunroof so you can see if the lenses change a little bit in that environment. And then finally, I'll step outside the car and let them change fully so you can see that change as well. This is not completely scientific. Your lenses, if you're wearing them in an area with more tree cover or less tree cover or in a different state or a different time of year might behave a little bit differently than this, but this is just to show you kind of the difference between the lenses. All right, let's check out the first pair of glasses. So the first one I'm gonna try, by the way, these are sunglasses. This is the Salt DeBerge. Ooh. The first ones I've got for you, this is going to be Transition Signature 7 in gray. All of the lenses I've picked for you today are gray varieties. In my last video about Sig 7 versus Xtractive that my friend Claire and I did, we actually did a gray versus a brown, which was not the best example. I'll redo that video at some point. But today I do have all gray examples. So this is the first one. This is Transition Sig 7. I was holding it in my hand a little bit while I was talking, and so it might have changed a little bit, but as I'm sitting here, you can kind of see how it's changing. And my car windshield here in front of me has UV protection in it, so that's reducing how much it changes. This window over here to the side, most of your driver's side and passenger side windows don't have UV protection. So it is changing a little bit, probably especially as I move over there, but you can kind of get a sense. We've got a light tint. All right, so now I'm gonna open up the sunroof. So here, we're gonna let them change a little bit more. So, I think you would agree, they've gotten a lot darker since I've been sitting here with the sunroof open. And granted, now we've got open air above me, UV protection in front of me, and no UV protection to the side. So I am getting the sun's rays kind of from two different areas, and they've definitely darkened up a little bit. So finally, we're gonna move outside and show you what it's like in full sunshine. This is the Transition Signature 7 lens. It's in a gray color. Again, this lens has been discontinued. You're not gonna find this to purchase it anymore, but if this is the lens you've been wearing, this is kind of the base to compare the other lenses to. So this should be fully turned. Sun's up pretty well today. There's a little bit of cloud cover, but it's close to, I mean, we're in the 90 degree mark. It's a very sunny day, and this is how much they've changed. The next lens I'm gonna show you is the newest lens from Transitions. It just came out this summer, July 2019, and this is their Generation 8 lens. If you compare Signature 7 to Generation 8, what you'll see is more darkening in the Generation 8 and more quickly. So what I love about it is that it's changing when you go inside a little bit faster to being clear, as well as getting dark faster when you're in a vehicle. Or even just outside. So I love that the lens gets dark quicker and also back light quicker when you compare it to the Signature 7. So I want to show you this Gen 8 pair of glasses in the car so you can see what it's going to be like behind your car windshield when you're driving around, as well as with the sunroof open and then outside, just like I did for 6-7. So let's take a look at it. I'm going to get my sunglasses off and get these on as quickly as I can. This is my new pair of Gen 8s that they just sent me a couple months ago. You can check out the video for this pair of glasses. The unboxing video should be linked below. All right, so I'm sitting here and letting it turn. And this is, of course, with, of course, UV protection in front of me. Sunroof is closed. And I'm getting a little bit of UV potentially turning them from this side. I would say that the tint is kind of fairly light at this point. I'm not seeing subjectively a ton of darkening. So you're gonna have kind of a light tint for when you're driving around, which is doable. It kind of depends where you live, but I think that, you know, you'll have a little bit of extra sun protection. Your eyes will feel a little bit better than just wearing clear glasses. So let's go ahead and open the sunroof. All right, as you can see, they turned dark rather quickly there as soon as we had UV in the picture. And again, my sunroof is open, and this is the color that they're gonna be. So let's hop outside and see if they get any darker. So this is this Transitions Generation 8, the newest lens. This is the one you'll be getting if you say, I want regular Transitions. This is gonna be the default. This lens is really dark at this point. My eyes feel very comfortable. I don't feel like I'm squinting at all. Of course, you're gonna get the most, you're gonna get the darkest color when you are outside in full exposure of UV like this. But you can kind of compare how they looked in the car and with the sunroof open to see if it's the right choice for you. All right, I'm back in the car and I'm gonna show you the last pair of glasses, which is Transitions Xtractive, also in a gray tint. These theoretically should get the darkest, not only by behind the car windshield, but also when we're outside as well. So I've got them on right out of the case. Remember from my other videos that your Transitions Xtractive is actually gonna be slightly tinted even indoors. This lens does have a little bit of a tint at all times, but then outdoors and especially behind a car windshield, they're supposed to get a lot darker. And that's what we're looking to see if we can tell today. So again, I'm in the same spot as I was for the Sig 7 and Generation 8 lenses. I'm just sitting here with a UV protectant front windshield in front of me and non-UV protective side over here. And this is what they look like. So here is Xtractive, just hanging out in my car with the sunroof closed, normal day. And then let's open the sunroof and see if we get some extra darkening. Okay, so I definitely think that we're getting some more darkening here. I can see it. My eyes, I would say, feel more comfortable than they did in both of the regular varieties of lenses. I personally feel, you know, subjectively like it is a little bit darker and more like a sunglass. Now, none of these lenses when they're turned are like having a full-on sunglass. And so ultimately, if you're looking for that, you should do a separate pair of prescription sunglasses. And in fact, that's something that I always recommend for my patients anyway, because there are just times when that's gonna be more comfortable on your eyes. But transitions for me are really something that you can wear, pop in and out of the car, do errands. I was joking before, but you know, pick up your groceries at Target with the baby in the back and feel like your eyes are protected and you're not squinting in the sunlight. And I think that they actually look really cool as well. These are all gray versions of the, you know, transitions, but some of the new colors you can kind of match to your frame itself, and I think that that looks really good aesthetically as well. So we've shown it to you, you know, in my car closed up, and now with the sunroof open, we've got one more look to show you with the Xtractive. Let's go outside and see how much they turn. All right, so we've got the Xtractive lenses and I'm just letting them turn. The sun is right here to my right. I definitely feel like they're more comfortable. They're a lot darker. I can personally tell the difference between the regular varieties and Xtractive. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this in the car trial of Signature 7 versus Generation 8 versus Xtractive. You've all been asking for this video, so I hope it helped seeing the lenses in different environments. If you haven't already, make sure to like our channel, subscribe, hit the bell, all the stuff that you do. We greatly appreciate having you here. We have new videos coming out every single Wednesday at 4 o'clock, and I'll see you next time.